disseminating and documenting those lessons. So those kind of things have been lost. And so we don't have that rich evidence base to make decisions. So intuitively we can feel that there's opportunities here, but we haven't got that kind of the numbers, the evidence to back that up yet, which is a barrier when you have to go to your local politicians, and for when the private sector has to go to their board saying, I want to do this, I want to invest this kind of money, yeah, where's your proof, where's your evidence? So that's I think that's a problem. Linked to that is actually, again, putting all those kind of benefits into a transport situation doesn't really exist either. So in terms of actually how can you, in terms of transport specific use cases, so if you wanted to do the visa service or you wanted to improve access to a rail station and stuff like that, there's no kind of documentation of how you would do that. And again, that's a challenge. I also think there's actually, in reality of all this, there's actually very little incentive for people to share their data, actually, the truth of it. It's not a costless activity. We can talk about, well, we make more data open and stuff like that. We understand that's not costless. You've got to do something and it has a resource cost, has a financial cost. There's some risks, perhaps mostly perceived risks, of releasing that data. What are other people going to do with it? Am I going to breach data security regulations, GDPR, all that kind of stuff? So it's kind of, what's in it for me is all very, very difficult. And again, that leads us to missing out on opportunities. Another challenge which I think